designed this guitar with our luthier. It was supposed to be the ultimate slide guitar, and it was crap. Like a completely, utterly wrong assumption about what would work. It's got a big wide neck, but the neck's too flat, and it just goes clank, clank, clank. So I didn't use it for a while. It's a very expensive thing to have lying around. And then I rethought it. So I down-tuned it, and it's now my G guitar, and for some reason it works beautifully. For the benefit of the anorex, open G, very important tuning. When the Stones first recorded in the States, Ryle Cooder was in the next studio, and of course they couldn't help but worship at the feet of the wonderful Mr. Ryle Cooder, who immediately pointed out that most slide playing in the blues was actually done in open tunings anyway. And that's where Keith got hold of the idea of down tuning and G tuning a guitar, and then even threw away the bottom D string as well. So that's why when he plays those riffs, it's on the guitar that appears to have five strings, because it does. Then, what else? It's all kinds of stuff, you know. So. Joni Mitchell, great exponent of the G. I use it for faking modal tunings. It's my favourite general purpose tuning. This is a broadside ballad set to music by the wonderful Nick Jones, huge hero of mine, fantastic player and interpreter of traditional music, and one of the funkiest acoustic guitarists ever on the planet. Great, great guy. And what I like about broadside ballads is that it's the news. It's basically, I never felt more like singing the news. That's exactly what it is, you know, because news was always at least 6 months late, and it was pushed around in wheelbarrows, and people shouted it in the street, and if you had money, you paid your halfpenny or your farthing or your mite or your groat, and you got the news, basically. Wouldn't it be nice if the news came that way now? Because again, maybe I'm showing my age again, but I'm sick of having the news read to me by people I feel I need to explain it to. I'm a fully paid up member of the Bring Back Moira campaign. Called the Warlike Lads of Russia, and it's got lots of verses, and I nearly always trip up somewhere on the line, so if one of the verses comes out twice as loud and in reverse, you'll know that I've just suddenly stepped over the line into genuine frontier gibberish, okay? And but there's lots of verses, there's enough verses to make the story plain. And what this reminds me of, in fact, is a cartoon that I had when I was a kid from Punch magazine, probably 1964-65. There was a banner at the bottom, or a footer in that case, they call footers on there. And it's Napoleon retreating from Moscow on his horse, and he's going, sorry, Fossey.
Oh, mad.
Grumbling to himself in French. And behind him is the remains of his raggle-taggle army, and they're all glaring at him. And 20,000 snowballs are about to hit him on the back of the head. This is a cracking chorus. I'll keep banging on about choruses because it seems to me that every day we're restricted from doing something more. I bet community singing is next on the health and safety. On the grounds that you might poke your throat and somebody else will have to pay for it. So make the most of it. The warlike lads of Russia, they fought all in one mind. They made Bonaparte to run and leave his troops behind. Take a Russian country, they were full employed by the Russians. step retreat. Leave the Bonaparte nor Wallace men what anything could get. And from Muscovy City, oh, the Russians took their flight. They set the town on fire and they burnt it down that night. All the Warlike of Russia, they fought all in one might. They made Bonaparte to run and leave his troops behind. Now into Muscovy City, oh, the Russians did attack. Against Bonaparte and all his men, they killed them, took them, drove them back. But the action being so hot from right and left and front and rear, oh, damn you, sizzle, Bonaparte, I'll stay no longer here. Oh, the Warlike lads of Russia, they fought all in one might. They made Bonaparte to run and leave his troops behind. Then away then went Bob Bonaparte as fast as he could run. All the hedges and the ditches he left, horses, men and guns. His boxes and his matches, munition, wagons too. Well, he left them all behind him, what else could poor Boney do? All the Warlike lads of Russia, they fought all in one mind. They made Bonaparte to run and leave his troops behind. Then away then went Bob Bonaparte as fast as he could ride. And the poor Frenchman looked after him, saying, oh, it's very hard. But to think you'd leave us all out there and lead us to our fate. Oh, you ought to stop along with us and help us in our state. Oh, the Warlike lads of Russia, they fought all in one might. They made Bonaparte to run and leave his troops behind. Now here's 80,000 men from me, they killed them, they've taken. Besides 10,000 horses, 200 bits again. And never more to Paris or French Flanders, I'll advance. For if I do, I may be sure they'll teach me how to dance. All the Warlike lads of Russia, they fought all in one mind. They made Bonaparte to run and leave his troops behind. And it's too concluded thus to try and finish off my song. All Boney's made the Russians swear they wish they'd hold of him. And the cruelest death they put into that ever did a man before. Of course, yes, as old Bonaparte, I'm clear of the war. All the Warlike lads of Russia,